Welcome to the beautiful Styrian Mountains for another chapter in the story of the Austrian Grand Prix. The Spielberg circuit then is situated 700 meters above sea level, with just 10 corners making up one of the shortest laps of the season. One time around here is a distance of 2.6 miles, with the best overtaking chances into turn one or the tight uphill turn three. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of turn one. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
Well, the throttle goes both ways, Crofty. You've got to have the discipline not to try and win the race on the first lap. So always be prepared to lift early and give those around you more space. Trying to be the last of the late breakers with half a dozen cars around you may pay off from time to time, but it's also a great way to lose your front wing.
It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Leclerc, Vettel, Max Verstappen, and Stroll, Albon, Perez, Norris, and Kevin Magnussen, Sainz, Ricciardo, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Ocon, the rookie, Grosjean, Pierre Gasly, and Kimi Raikkonen, Kvyat, Russell, Correa, and Nicholas Latifi. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
Good on the power unit cycle, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature. first lap. Keep it up. Is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Fuel. Try shifting up the gears a little sooner. This should help us save some fuel. Clear. Some information on Gasly. They've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. The car in front is 2.2 seconds. Beginning to pull away. I think we may see some rain. ETA is about 15 minutes. Tire condition for now, everything's looking good. Gap to teammate behind is 7.0 seconds. We'll be right back. is 3.2 seconds. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the hards. Radar suggests some weather is going to hit in around 5 minutes' time, so stay on your toes. Dries seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. Our gap to the car in front is 3.7 seconds. Box, we're coming in this lap. Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead. Green flag. Go, go. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tires. well is coming in for his stop. Has come in to fit the mediums. Car ahead, now running medium tyres. The gap to the car ahead is 10.2 seconds. Burned off our excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine down. Expecting some rain soon. Expect the first drops in the next few minutes. We're still on the right tyres for the time being. Gap to car in front is 5.5 seconds. leading our teammate by 15.9 seconds. Okay, even though we're seeing cars struggle in these conditions, if we pit for inters now, we're going to be too slow and we'll burn them out. Make the best of it for the time being. We're seeing a loss of power from the turbocharger now. Loss of power on the turbo. Okay, gap ahead is 7.3 seconds. Okay, I think it might be just about time to come and change these tyres. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Confirmed. Left of this rain, then we think it's going to dry up. 10 minutes. Exit now. You'll be racing as you leave the pits. Complete. Go now. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Is coming in for his stop. Pushing. The car behind can't keep up with the pace. We think they're struggling with fuel. Our gap to the car in front is 11.0 seconds. Gap to teammate behind is 25.0 seconds. Fuel target is plus one. Faster engine modes are available. Gap to the car ahead is 1.8 seconds. looks like some of those puddles are clearing. We're still on the right tyre for the time being, but we're not a million miles away from slick conditions. Looks like we'll be running on a dry track soon. Back to dry shortly. Catching the car ahead, but be aware that these tyres need to last till the end of the race. Gap to car in front is 2.3 seconds. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Got that confirmed. Release, release. Juan Manuel is in the pits. Juan Manuel in the pits. Behind is 2.7 seconds. Okay, gap ahead is 1.5 seconds. P12, we have P12. Raikkonen is ahead of you. Our gap to the car in front is 1.5 seconds. They're on fresh softs. Kvyat behind. The gap to the car behind is 2.8 seconds. They're on fresh softs. The distance to the leader is 32.3 seconds. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. 5 laps till the end. We're leading our teammate by 32.8 seconds. there's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Managing your tyres, manage your tyres. This is your final lap of the race. Race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
So, another fantastic victory for the Silver Arrows. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs. And that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team. And they certainly deserve it. Now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. Some amazing talents out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
That's got to be the Flying Finn. Wait, how many Flying Finns have we had now? Anyway, I'm talking about Bottas this time. Just great raw speed. and a good job in traffic as well.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team.